Chicago over New York. I mean, I think New York is closer, but Chicago is like the data hub, I guess, so maybe better pick Chicago. I don't know. Okay, we should be live view. Oh, whoa. Yeah, we're live. I love the sock puppet. It's awesome.
Thank you.
It's awesome.
Did you make the one?
We should be live.
We're live. Yeah, I did make that by hand. I had actually had to hide it because my cat was trying to kill it.
Oh.
No. Oh, wow.
That
Thanks,
sounds
Julie.
familiar.
Excellent. Everyone can hear us.
Okay, and I have everything closed that I don't need open.
Okay. Excellent.
Let me just open up Task Manager. Performance and Ethernet, and yeah, we're okay. I actually copied the video files onto the laptop so the kids can watch it without having to kill my bandwidth. So they're downstairs, and we moved the couch around too and all that stuff. So
Okay.
they're like off in the corner of the basement. Because last time that they were there, they were sitting right beneath the vent, and any little sound, I could hear it, right? Because it just
Yeah.
carries up. But now they're
Oh, well,
okay.
that's a good idea.
Yeah, we moved them. We just need to get a cheap TV, and then they can have their own little TV area down there if they want.
Oh, that's a good idea.
I'm a little hesitant. I kind of want them to have it, but I don't want them to abuse it, right? Because they could just be down there the whole day.
Can you put a parental lock on it?
Depends on the TV, right?
Yeah, true.
So.
Oh, I thought would have thought most of them do that nowadays. Maybe check it out and
Well, that's
see.
if it's a new TV. Like I said, if it's not new, it's
Yeah.
I'm gonna be cheaping it out.
Yeah.
I got no money
Oh.
now. I got no money. I'm broke.
Money.
Had to get a
Money,
car, man.
money.
Because the other car took all my money, and now we have to get a new car. Stupid old car.
No,
Okay.
stupid car.
We are
Okay.
now live. I'm just going to tweet out again. We are now live with. Oops. Oh, let's do short form with. And it is NiseyBGN, right? With no underscore. For Twitter?
For Twitter, the you know what? Now that I'm put on the spot.
Yeah, I don't think it is. Let me see. It's pretty
No,
sure.
no
No, yeah,
underscore on
there's no
Twitter.
underscore.
It's just the
Yes.
capital BGN.
Right. I'm like, yes. I didn't
I had to
screw it
get my
up.
guild tagged on there, so.
Oh, I was gonna ask you about that on the show. So you can talk about that on the show, like when we're live and all that. For episode, cannot type 35. Wow. There we go. And then when I start getting typing, then I'm good to go. Okay. There we go. It's tweeted. Shut that down. Shut that down. I don't need email. Twitch show notes. Good. Okay. Ready to go? Okay. You see?
Yep, all set.
Oh.
All right.
Kidoki. Let's see if the intro plays. All right.
Iron Man. Bloodthirsty. Pacifist. You're listening to the WoW Challenges podcast, the home of the Iron Man Challenge. And here are your hosts, Stone and Leeta.
Hello and welcome to the WoW Challenges podcast, episode number 35. Today is Saturday, September the 10th, 2016. I am your host, Stone, and joining me is my co-host, Leeta. See? Told you I could do it.
Nice.
Hi, Leeta.
Hey, Stone. I had a feeling that you were going to do the intro today.
Oh,
Very
because
nice.
did I give it away with all my talking? about the other stuff?
No.
Oh, okay.
No. Okay. That was good. I'm doing well. How are you?
I've got a beer. Great.
As long as you've got a beer and I've got coffee, we're all good. Yes. Excellent. Alrighty. Well, we have got a very special guest with us today, and we have to say a big thank you. Nisey's come and joined us today. So thank you, Nisey. How are you?
I'm good. Very good. How are you guys doing today?
We are doing great. And thanks even better coming. Now that we've got you here to have a little chat with us. So, first off, tell us a little bit about you. So who are you? What do you do behind the wowing, challenging stuff?
Well, actually, right now, not a whole lot. Kind of doing the housewife thing and helping take care of my father. And I do some art on the side a little bit and just kind of hang out and play WoW. I do a little bit of other Blizzard games and just kind of just here.
Excellent. And what other games do you like to play? So obviously WoW is a big part, but which other ones do you like?
I do a little bit of Overwatch and also do some Hearthstone as well.
Nice.
A little bit of Diablo 3. A little bit.
Uh-huh. Okay. Cool. So who's your favorite Overwatch that you like to play?
Oh, gosh. I guess my go-to would be Lucio. And then probably Mercy and then D.Va.
Not a Soldier like 76 fan.
I do go to 76 once in a while.
Once in a while?
Okay. Oh, cool. Alrighty. I am hopeless at it, so.
you and I should play then.
What? I'll give you run for...
All three of us should just play. All three of us should play, and then we could team up on you. Target practice.
There's some things I'm good at and some things I'm not, and it's fun, but yeah. I really just am not good at it. So anyway, alrighty. Well, Nisey, how long have you been playing WoW?
Started a little bit after BC launched. My husband got me playing.
Okay, and when did he start playing? Has he been playing longer than you? A lot longer?
He played a couple months before I did, and I'd been kind of watching over his shoulder, and I'm like, what are you doing? What are you doing? And he's like, why don't you just play? And I'm like, no. And he's like, no, come on, play. So then him and his current guildmaster challenged us both to see who could get to level 40 first. And I'm like, all right, fine, I'll play.
Nice. So he still plays now?
Yes, he plays. Unfortunately, there's a story he won't let me live down about that. I had started playing. We were sharing one account when I first started, and I decided that I wanted to play. Well, I had this character now to level 40. It was like a huge accomplishment in BC, and he's like, well, you know, I'll get you your own account. And I'm like, but my character at 40 is on your account. And so he deleted his highest character and let me have his account, got a new account, and then I ended up deleting that character. So he was...
Wow.
Yeah, he never lets me live it down to this day. So.
Yeah, that's pretty funny, though. That is pretty funny. Yeah. Alrighty, so when did you first start trying the challenge characters? When did that come along?
I think I first looked at it at some point in Kata. One of my guild members had mentioned it, and I was like, oh, that seems kind of different, and I was trying to do the Iron Man a little bit. I started out on a druid. I'm like, oh yeah, I really want to level a druid. Got to like Ashamil and died like three times. I'm like, yeah, no. I'll come back to this later because we got to see with raiding and stuff. And I'm like, okay. Well, I didn't really go back to it till I guess last October or November. And I started doing the Iron Man again. And everybody's like, oh, you know, go Hunter. Well, Hunters and I don't get along too well.
Okay.
Every time I got to Stranglethorn, I was dead. And I'm like, this isn't working. So I was like, let me try Bloodthirsty. At least then I can control what's going to kill me because I'm not doing a quest where I have to kill this mob. So I started doing that. Started out on a Hunter. I'm like, yeah, no, died. So I was like, you know what? Priest is my main class. Let's go Priest. And I've been doing fairly well on the Bloodthirsty. What times I have died, except for one, have been my own stupidity.
Nice. So your current is not is priest, night elf priest?
My current is a blood elf priest at the moment.
Blood elf priest.
Okay. I was doing alliance, and I just kept dying, and you know, I'm like, you know what, maybe I'm just too familiar with these alliance zones. Maybe I need to go to the other side of the faction, and maybe that'll keep me a little more aware of where I'm at.
Yep. Yeah, there is something to be said about familiarity can be a good thing, but it can sometimes also be a bad thing. So that's kind of...
Yeah, especially on Bloodthirsty, because I'm like sitting there and I'll like have something playing on the background and I'll catch myself like zoning out and I'm like, oh my god, where am I?
Yeah. Yeah. Yes, that's never a good thing. Zoning out, losing track of what you're doing. Yeah, that always ends up with me dead.
Oh, there's a flag, right?
Okay. So Bloodthirsty is your primary challenge. Have you tried the pacifist at all, or is it something you'd like to try?
I have actually tried it. I do have a pacifist sitting at level 17. I got so wrapped into working on Bloodthirsty that I just haven't gotten back to him since.
Okay. All right. And I'm sorry. Are you sorry?
I said I'm sorry. It's pacifist. I can't do it.
I'm not sure if I want to try now, because I'm like, oh god. I'm afraid for Legion if I make it that far. I'm like, oh, I don't know.
Once you get to 20, it's a little bit better, but until then, blah. Blah. That's all I have to kind of say. Blah.
Blah. Nice. Alrighty. And do you feel like you would try the Iron Man challenge again at some stage, or just more focused into Bloodthirsty?
I might try it again at some point, but definitely not on a Hunter.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Sometimes I always find with classes, you know, when you go something, stick with what you know. I mean, we know Hunters have been fantastic, but if you're not strong in that area, Priest, that's awesome. They were pretty good before in
Priest
Drenor.
Yep.
They were awesome. I haven't tried my Priest since the, you know, everything's dropped, but I mean, she was kicking butt. Mine was.
Yeah, like when pre-patch came in and the changes came in, it kind of threw me a little bit, and I was actually on the beta, and I had taken off all my gear, and I just threw a level 100 in there, and I was trying to do stuff like down on the docks, the pre-scenario invasion, and I was dying left and right. I was like, oh god, I'm like so scared for when I get to Legion, but I'm hoping, you know, now that we can skip the scenario stuff, that it shouldn't be a problem.
Yeah.
Hmm.
Yeah, and I would say that, you know, sure, Hunter was good before, but, I mean, now with the changes, I think you could go on pretty much any class and just go. I mean, I still think Hunter will probably still be higher, but...
Level?
Yeah, I mean, I think being able to be in any spec really gives you a bump, right? So, you know...
Oh, definitely.
So...
I have noticed a big change when the specs came in. It's still a grind, but it's not the absolute slog that it was. And with having a few more spells to hit, it kind of keeps you a little bit more aware of, you know, where you are and your surroundings, so you don't zone out quite as hard, but it has made it a little bit faster. But in the same respect, then as you're going faster, you're like, oh yeah, you know, I can take this on, I can take that on. And my husband's like saying, you're killing stuff that you shouldn't be. You know, that stuff's like dark orange to you. And I'm like, I'm fine, I got it. And he's like, well,
that's good. He's supporting. He's being very supportive and encouraging, and being that little, you know, that little person on your shoulder, just sort of saying, "Do you think you should be over here doing this?" That's nice of him to help you out.
Yeah, it helps when I listen to it too. So I don't always.
Nice. So, what has been your fondest challenge memory so far?
See, just the fact that I've been able to get as high as I have just straight questing and been able to stick with it so far. I mean, you know, a couple of deaths have been hard, but I hit level 50 the other night, And I'm like, oh, wow, you know, I did that straight, no gear, just white and the gray gear. And like, you know, it took a while, but, you know, that was just like a huge accomplishment for me. I was like, and just the people that I've been meeting as I'm going, like, they'll just stop and they're like staring at me and they're following me. And I'm like, what? And I'm thinking, do they think I'm like a bot? Or do they think I'm just stupid and don't know what I'm doing? So I've had to like actually explain to a couple people. One person's like, you're in white and gray gear. I'm like, yeah, I know. And then I had to explain about the challenge. And they're like, oh, cool, good luck, and all that other stuff. But, you know, other people were just following me. I'm like, what are you doing? Like, go away.
Yeah.
You're messing up my respawn timers. Go away.
Yeah. Yeah. You're throwing off my chi, buddy. Go away. Oh. Alrighty. So what zones have you been concentrating on with your leveling of your bloodthirsty? So do you want to just kind of run us through how you started off to get up to the point that you are at the moment?
Okay, let's see. I'll try to remember because I'm not used to the horde side. I ended up doing the blood elf starting area.
Mm-hmm.
And then I was very carefully picking my way through Ghostlands because there's a couple of elites out there that I was desperately trying to avoid. And just like, stay over there. And then when I got through there, I'm like, well, where do I go from here? So I ended up coming down to Hillsbrad. And unfortunately, or maybe fortunately, the invasions had started. And I'm like, oh, okay. So now what? And I kind of couldn't go anywhere past Hills, Silverpine. I couldn't go into mm-hmm. Hillsbrad. And I was like, oh dear. So then I said, well, let me just sit for a little bit. So I started doing the invasions on my main. And I'm like, you know, this isn't too bad. And I said, you know, maybe if I can get close enough where I'm in a good spot, maybe I can just get a little bit of XP bump. So that way, you know, it's still within the rules, but, you know, yeah, it'll help me get back because I had just died recently and I was really mad. So I was like, let me try to get back up there faster. And so I was kind of hanging out in Hillsbrad and Arathi for a little bit, and I was killing some stuff in between invasions. And then I from there, where did I go? From Hillsbrad, I went to Arathi.
Mm-hmm.
And then from Arathi, I think I had gotten enough XP where I went to Fellwood, and then from Fellwood I went up to Winterspring, and I'm kind of chilling out up near Everlook right now, killing the Yetis.
Okay. And do you concentrate on keeping like the mobs at being green, yellow, or orange? Like, what's your strategy with killing mobs?
Well, I've been noticing, like, I've been trying to play a little bit of Rusted because if I can usually take on in the Discipline Spec stuff that's kind of orange to me without too much of a problem. So, and then, you know, killing the oranges when you're Rested, I was getting, like, chunks of XP, like 630 a kill, and I'm like, oh, we gotta keep doing this. So usually when stuff hits green, I try to move on to another higher level section.
Do you have a plan for going into Hellfire? Are you, are you going to go right in at 58 or are you going to wait till 660?
You know, I've been agonizing over that. I'm like, what do I do? Because people are like, oh yeah, Hellfire is just... everything hits so hard at level 60 or like right before it, and I'm like, yeah, but was that before specs? And I was like, well, I can heal myself, but I think I might wait till 60 and get my flying and then get some exploration XP and then head on over to Zanger is like my favorite zone out there, and I pretty much know where everything is. Okay. So I figure I'll be safer there.
Zanger would just... be a great place for killing mobs.
Yeah, I think I'm just going to try to avoid Hellfire as much as possible because I have nightmares of the Fell Reaver when I was leveling through there in BC originally, and I'm like, oh god, where is it?
Yes.
Fell Reaver. Yes.
Fell Reaver, yes. Most definitely.
We have Alrighty. A clean tag on the show, right? So mm-hmm. otherwise, I want to swear. I really want to swear. Really bad. Mm.
Yeah,
well, I'll swear after the show.
Okay, you can do that. We will allow you to do that. What I want to know, Nisey, is what has been one of your worst deaths or embarrassing deaths? Like, when you've had deaths with your toons, what's something that's either been that you just, like, facepalm, like me when I got one-shotted by the guard over at stupid place? Be careful where you're flying to.
Yes.
But, yeah, so... deaths are always, I wouldn't say they're a fun thing, but they're the thing that really, really sticks. It really hurts. So what's something that's really, really hurt you when you've had a death on a toon?
Well, I had two, and I can't decide which one hurt worse.
Okay.
Heal Nova hurt pretty bad because I still am not sure if it was a glitch with a poison debuff or if it was an invisible mob, and nothing I did was making it better. And I just had to sit there and watch her die because I was out of mana and could not heal myself. That hurt pretty bad. Soulfully died to my own stupidity, and that one was just such a big facepalm. It was getting late, and I was starting to get tired. I was like, you know, I should probably wrap up soon, and I'm looking at my XP bar, and I had like 30% left in the level, and I'm like, you know what? I can do this tonight. I can do this. So I'm killing Yetis, and I was like, you know what? There's that Yeti cave up there. I bet you I can get in and back out and have most of this, what I've got left, done. Got in, no problem. And I got to the end of the cave. Everything was dead. I was like, you know, I can probably work my way back out and I'll be fine. Little voice inside my head's like, you're going to hearth now, right? And I'm like, no, I got this. And little voice is like, you really should hearth and then just come back. And I'm like, no, I'm good. I started to come back out. And everything respawned on top of me. And I'm like, oh, God. And I had one. I'm like, okay, I can handle this one. However, there was another one around the corner that came with it. And I'm like, oh, okay, two. I'm good. I'll pop Shadow Fiend. We're good. Well, then a third one respawned on top of me. And I'm like, oh, no. I'm like, maybe I can do this. And I'm like, okay, let's bubble. Let's heal. And I said, if I can get one down, two left is good. And then... a fourth one showed up, and I'm like, where are you coming from? And I panicked, and I hit Psychic Scream, and I tried to run for it, and I just created more of a mess than it would have been, and I ended up dying trying to run out, and I was like, no. I just sat there and stared at my screen. I was like, I should have hearthed.
I always think it's quite amusing when that little inner voice comes back and just goes, you know what you should have done. And you're just like,
yeah, my husband was standing behind me. He's like, why did you do that? And I'm like, because I'm dumb. That's why I did that. Because I'm dumb.
Is she tired?
Like, you should have heard.
Yeah. Oh, wow. So what do you think has been the most unfriendly zone? I mean, other than these things, but in your travels with your toons, have you just come up against a zone and just gone, nope, I'm not going there? Or you've gone through the zone and you're just like, yeah, I don't think I'll do that zone ever again.
Oh, boy. Well... I'm kind of iffy on Winterspring, where I am right now. Certain mobs are good. Certain mobs, I'm like, oh, God, no, not yet. And I'm hoping that they get better. But before the spec change came in, everybody's like, oh, yeah, you know, we usually, you know, when you hit, like, 40, you go to Eastern Plague. And I'm like, all right. So I was in Eastern Plague, and I'm trying to kill stuff. And I'm like, oh, my God, this stuff is hitting so much harder. And I was killing these grubs. Thought I had a really good path planned out. I'm like, okay, I'm good right where I am. There shouldn't be anything patrolling into me. Mm-hmm. And stuff patrolled into me and killed me. And I'm like, I'm not doing this zone ever, ever, ever again because these gargoyles just come out of nowhere.
Yeah.
They've got such a long path zone. And I'm like, yeah, no, you weren't there 5 minutes ago. So I really didn't like Eastern Plague at all.
Yes, it can be a very temperamental zone.
I've heard it's actually pretty good.
I think it has felt a little bit better since the spec change came in, but before the spec change, it was bad.
Okay.
Yeah.
Or at least for my class, it was bad.
Okay. Alrighty. Now, what advice would you give to anyone wanting to try a challenge toon? And do you have any tips or tricks that you like to utilize when you play your challenge toons?
Definitely go with a race that you're comfortable with, and definitely go with a class that you're comfortable with. Because sometimes those racial combos can come in really, really great. If you get stunned or something, the gnomes have their little engineers, escape artist thing. Or, you know, I was going hardcore Drenai for a while because they had their self-heal built into their to the race. And that did cover my ass a couple times. But you know, it's just go with what you know. And you can't go into it expecting the first time you're going to try it that you're going to live. You're going to die. It's going to happen, but you just got to keep trying again. It's like, okay, well, now I have a goal of passing this level. And then just keep telling yourself, okay, well, I died here. Now I have to try to get past that level. Because it's a little rough, and until you know your zones and you know what your class is capable of, it's going to happen.
Yeah. No, I think that's some really good advice there. So, excellent. Well, good luck. So, your priest is at level 50, or is she a bit
higher? She just hit 50 the other night. And armory is still not updating for me. She's a couple of bubbles in through 50.
Nice. Oh, that's fantastic. Congratulations.
And thank you.
We wish you all the best, and we can't wait to see your journey with her, especially when you get a little bit higher, see how you go with going into Zangamash. So have
yeah,
fun
right now
that.
My goal is just staying alive till 60, so we'll see. Fingers crossed.
60 is always a good number to aim for, definitely. So yeah, awesome. All right, well, Stone, news?
Sure.
Breaking now, news from the World of Warcraft with Leeta and Stone.
I have no news. I just wanted to play the clip. That's all. Yeah, there's been hot fixes, but from what I remember, I don't really know if they really applied to us. I mean, there were hot fixes to classes. They've been doing hot fixes. I think I've seen them like on the 6th, 7th, 8th, 9th. So they are trying to roll these things out a lot. And they don't require realms to be rebooted. They're able to make the changes behind the scenes, and we're just gonna deal with them. And sometimes they announce it, sometimes they don't. So I know that they made some changes to leather drop rates for pacifists. Or no, actually that wouldn't matter because you're skinning, so it doesn't matter. Things like how effective certain items are, they actually changed it. Without actually saying anything. So they have hot fixes, and then they have secret hot fixes. So I think we're still in the period of
SHF, secret hot fixes.
Yes, of things happening.
I had to think about that one. Okay, all right, well, excellent. All right, site news, what have we got?
So I was going to say, it looks like the API is fixed, and if you don't know the API, that's how we get our info. So we just we get a special key, and we get the info from Blizzard, and they send us all the stuff on any character that we want. And since August 30th, it was sending us old information. Mm-hmm. And, you know, I've been seeing quite a few people are now changed. Now, not everybody. So, you know, I think the API is okay. It's that they did add a bunch of new things to it. And that did not come into effect until August the 30th. And I think because those things are new, the information had to get, what's a good word for it? Massaged, okay? Mm-hmm. Okay? For it to be used by us. And I don't think that's been completed yet. And I think for some folks it is. For other folks like yourself and Nisey, it's not. So we're still looking. And
yeah, it's really strange because like my main, it's showing up-to-date achievements, but my main's level's not up-to-date. And on Soulbound, it's not showing anything up-to-date. I'm like,
wow.
Okay.
Yeah. And, you know, and you'll see when we start reading out who hit level what, you know, there's a huge jump, right? So that's one of the ways that I know that it's not completely fixed for everybody, because there wouldn't be a big jump in character levels as far as who reached what point, right? So for instance, in the next thing, like, we'll see somebody hit level somebody was red flagged at level 77, but then the next one is level 51, and that's a huge jump, right? So to me, that means that there's, you know, folks that are leveling up characters in between that are not getting picked up yet. So I would just say, you know, there's nothing I can fix on my side. It's, we just gotta wait for Blizzard to do it, and they definitely know about it. I did tweet at them like a goon. Like, I was like, so do you guys know when this is gonna be fixed? And they're like, yeah, we know it's happening. It's, we're trying to fix it, which is, I expected that to be their answer, because they can't give you a date, because if you give them, if they give us a date, then we're like, well, why isn't it fixed yet? And that's, you just don't give dates, right? So that's the thing. So I guess we just gotta wait. Sorry.
Okay.
Yeah.
Hmm. Alrighty. Yeah. Okay, so let's go on to, we have a state of the challenges. Yeah,
for what we've got, you know. Yes, yeah. We kind of do, so.
We do, which is exciting. All right, so I'm going to take the Iron Man. So here we go. So this week, we've got Iron Sui was hit 32.
I think so. Iron, I don't know.
40?
I saw that. 40? I was like, I make sure I spelled it right.
Excellent. Everyone knows. You guys know I butcher your name. Sorry. Steel Flaps. Hey, that's a good name.
That's a pretty cool name. Yeah.
That's pretty cool. Hit level 46. Congratulations. Lost Her. Hit level 51.
You know what? I never saw that, and I read it as like TH, right? So yep. I never didn't read it as two words. What a goon. All right. Anyways, go ahead. I'm such a derp.
Iron Monkey 77 red flag, 3 res equipped.
Yep. Sorry.
3?
Yep.
Oh, okay. Could that have to do with spec and the automatic equip?
If they have the automatic equip, then that's only 2, and that's okay.
Okay. Alrighty. Okay, Geekster, RIP level 80. Mm-hmm. Never Died H hit 101. Iron Ster hit 101. Iron Ashes hit 101. And Grey Archer hit 102, but they are yellow flag due to pet battling.
And I just want to make a point that this, I just checked just to make sure that the pet battling, it wasn't just because of his pet battling, because he did a little bit of pet battling right before he hit max level in WoD, and I wanted to see, well, is he still doing it or not? And yeah, he's doing it now, so I think the yellow flag is still there, because that's the rule that we have for it. So just so that you know, so to be official, you know, I don't want to take anything away from him, but if he were to hit 110, I don't know if I would necessarily say that he's a Iron Champion when somebody else were to hit 110 with a green flag. It's not the same, right? So it's,
well,
it's basically
not supposed to be pet battling anyway.
Right, but it's not a red flag, right? Right? So it's like, it's on that kind of borderline, kind of like, right? So, you know, I would be making a big thing about somebody hitting 110 and being green flagged over 110 in yellow, just so you know.
Yeah. Okay.
But right. You know, but still to, yeah, but still to get to 110 doesn't matter if you had to do pet battling or not. That's a lot of
at
pet
least
battles.
People are starting to make a move. So that's kind of cool to see, which is awesome. Yeah. Okay, Nisey, can you take the next slot, please?
Okay, Bloodthirsty. No movement, thank you, Armory.
Yes, yep.
Pacifists. Peaceful Guy hits 21. Joyful Vegan hits 25. Compassiona, 26. Ash Peaceful, is that 2 or Peaceful?
I think it's a 2.
Ash Peaceful 2, yeah. 28. And Umpa Pumpa, 36. Yeah.
That's a good name. I like that one too.
I was typing it out and I'm like, am I spelling it wrong? Because I was like, umpa pumpa.
You guys have some really creative names. I love it. It's awesome.
Yeah. So we've got 2 Rogue Slayers and Pacifist. So congratulations, Rogue Slayer. That's awesome. She's just pumping out the Pacifist. I didn't realize she was running 2. She must be doing 1 Horde, 1 Alliance, I would say. And Ash, my friend, Asheo, that's Ash Peace 2. So he's gone really good. Asheo? That's exciting.
I thought it was our Ash. Or my Ash. Nope. Okay.
It's my Ash. Okay. My Ash. Cool. Yeah. So that's cool. Congratulations, guys. Pacifist just blows my mind. So anyone who tries it, that is fantastic. So, yeah. So can't wait to see where everyone goes. Commiserations on everyone who lost or got flagged this week. It's never a fun thing. And for those that we did lose, so I'm ignoring you. For those that we did lose some tunes, so sorry about that. But good luck. Good luck for next week.
Wow, even luck? Good luck.
Good luck. Okay.
So, other stuff. All right.
Mm-hmm.
So there's a proposal brought up by our friend Ster, who's been on the show two times now. Yes, twice. And if you don't know who he is, dang it, Leeta.
It's catching. Oh no, I'm next.
He's the GM of basically the official Iron Man Guild Worm Rest Accord Alliance, U.S. Sorry. So basically, one of his things was, it would be kind of cool is if we could get people titles. So for instance, just to say how far you're able to reach. And, I think, so that, you could say, well, I may only want to be able to reach a certain point and then I might be good with that. Because, we're now getting to level 110. And even Blizzard knew that to go from 100, they were like, yeah, that could be a tough sell. Right, and that's why they began to offer boosts. Right, back in the day. Right, back in the last one. Right, so you could boost up to level 90 and then level up. So this is a similar thing where it's not a boost or anything. It's just just as a incentive kind of thing to say, well, now if you've reached level 60, well, now we call you a classic Iron. These titles are not set in stone yet, but. Heyo, I'll be here all week, folks. So things like if you hit level 80, you would be known as like a Iron Lich. Okay, it just something like that, so that that you hit the max level for that expansion. Okay.
Yeah.
We would always say that max level currently would always be labeled as a Iron Chat champion, because it's like that's how you know that you hit max when it was max, right? And so let's say for now, Legion it's 110, but when we get in to our next expansion, the dark bubble below, and you've heard it here, folks, that, you know, when we get up to 120, you know, the level 110 folks, when you start to make, when you start to hit that, you would then be known as like an Iron Legionnaire or something, right? But then the Iron Champion would actually move up to 120, right? So it's so that would always be a set bar that would always raise up, but we'd still have a title for the max level of that particular expansion. So it's sort of like achievement, and it's kind of incentive for folks to play, because they know, well, last time I reached, you know, 60, and this time I want to become known as a Iron Crusader, so that would be level 70. A Wrathful Iron. I think I actually like Wrathful Iron. Madness of Mine actually said this in chat. I actually like Wrathful Iron more than Iron Lich. I want it to be something that ties in with the name of the expansion, so that you know exactly what it is, right? And we would do it for all levels, right? So just because the Iron Man wasn't around for Classic doesn't mean that we wouldn't do it. So Classic Iron to hit level 60, I mean, it's, you know, should be fairly easy, well, easier, right? So, you know, it could be a goal, right? And, you know, if you die, then next time you can try to go higher. But then at least you could say, well, at least this character has this achievement. I'm not going to require logins yet, just because I'm not comfortable with it yet. I want to see what's going to come with the new website. That's one of the things too, is that I don't know if I'd be doing the titles and stuff until the new website is done, which Thule, I think, was in the chat room. Thule, again, I'm gonna get sidetracked. Anyway, I better not. So, Thule, thank you. So, because I'll just start going. You know, this is a thing that I think will incentivize participation. Yeah. Okay. I think it's a neat thing. I really easy to do, I think, with the way I think I was gonna do it. Idea.
Discussion on the forums, or
it was a proposal sent by him to me. So,
okay.
Just as a chat, and you know, and some folks had seen it, and I think it was a great idea, and other folks liked it, and you know, it was good.
Cool.
So, the other thing. Okay, and you know, Ster will, you know, he will be here next week. Okay, so I know we usually don't talk about who will be here next week, but he will be here next week to talk about some of this stuff that I'm going to talk about now. Okay, so, right now, if you go look at the Iron Man, which I am going to quickly look at and talk really slow so that the web page will load. Okay. So if you go look at the Iron Man site and you go look at the rules, we have 18 rules.
Mm-hmm.
Which, you know, you've got your core rules, and then you've got some of the rules that we've had to add because it seemed like folks were trying to take advantage of certain things, and you know, and we had to say, no, you can't do that, and no, you can't do this, no, you can't do that, and this and that, right? And I think, you know, I can see that as a new player, I can see as a player that wants to try this for the first time, they look at these rules and they're like, oh my lord. No, because they see a wall of text, right? So one of the thoughts going around is that, and this is not coming from me, but I asked if I could talk about it, and I got the thumbs up. So we're going to talk about it just a little bit right now, and we're going to talk about it more next week, okay? So we would want to make the rules a little bit more generalized and bring it back to basics. So that, not so that the challenge is easier, that's not the goal there, is so that it's not so like, like, no, the Iron Man is like this big page, just like if you print it out, if you were to print out the rules from my site right now, it's would be 2 pages guaranteed, okay? Mm-hmm. And yep, that's a bit much, I admit, to playing a challenge that, you know, it's supposed to be hard, absolutely. I would also venture to say it's supposed to be fun too. And over the last, I would say, well, I guess ever since April of 2015, we had a huge growth, I guess, right? And this was the efforts of everyone, right? Just to get our name out there and to remind people that if you don't have anything to do, try this, because lots of people have tried and it's hard to do, and only a few people have actually done it, right? So because we've had such a large amount of people playing, we definitely get more folks that are trying to be a rules lawyer, let's just say. And do you know what I mean? Where, you know, if you don't specify that, oh, I guess Skype is having fun with me right now. So if you don't specify that, you know, oh, well, you never said I couldn't use that particular food buff, then they would go use the food buff, right? And if we were to go do that, and this is the road where we began to go on, was that every single thing somebody would ask about, or if it looked like that they were beginning to kind of, try to find ways around the rule, and you're going to hear the Skype thing in and out, because Leeta's, I guess, having connection issues, which is okay. So when we start to get that, we start to have to make more rules and keep adding, right? And you know, one of the things of getting the rules generalized is actually not to make it vague, because that is the problem that we've come across already. It's actually to bring it back to what it was and let folks have fun. Make sure it's still hard, because it needs to be hard. It can't be something that somebody can just go and do, right? It's got to be something that folks can work at and then eventually do, right? I mean, if you go look at Warlords, we only had, we had 27 champions, which is actually our highest since Pandera. So in Cataclysm we had 12, in Pandaland we had 24, in Warlords we had 27, and actually 3 of those in Warlords came after the patch. So you could say that Warlords was about the same as Pandaland. So it means that things were okay. We don't know about Legion, right? So you know, we're definitely going to be talking a bit more about this, I guess, next week, and I think it's going to be, I guess, the focus of the show, because I mean, we've had him on before, Roguester has been on. He was on two weeks ago for our special anniversary show. So it's not like we need to go through the whole, hey, who are you again? It's a let's talk about what, you know, what what we think might be good to get people back in and have fun, right? And I think that from what we've seen over the last, I guess, where are we? September, I would say 3-4 months. Then I would say that if you, there's folks that are more interested in the rules than in having fun. And the challenge still needs to be hard. It's just that we need to not be rules lawyers kind of thing, right? So we're going to see what we need to do. And, you know, nothing set in stone again. And because it's so easy. So, you know, it's something that's just up for discussion. Okay. And, somebody told me once that when I managed to secure the Iron Man website name, they sent me a private message that actually I can't remember who it was, but I hold it dear to my heart that I am now the curator, and don't let us down, more or less, okay? And so when things have to change, it's, you know, I take it seriously. I really do. I want to try to make sure as many people are happy as we can, but knowing that we can't keep everybody happy. So we're going to talk about it next week for sure. And I would say definitely, if you have an opinion on it, Ster, I don't know if you would like to open a forum post or wait until next week. And after our discussion, he's in the chat room right now, so it's kind of weird to be talking to him on a podcast when he's not in the podcast. But just so that you guys know, I would say tune in for next week for sure. And just to go over some of the things that, you know, we might consider trying to change to make it a little bit more simple, and not have this big wall of text of rules that everyone needs to be like, oh my goodness, I have to memorize all this stuff, right? For instance, one of the things that kind of bugs me is, you know, we don't allow groups, absolutely, but one of the rules that we had to put in was the killing blows, right? And that's just more to kind of make sure that folks don't use groups, right? And if your character gets flagged, well, have fun with your flag. So, you know, and it's just something else that they need to worry about, where that rule wasn't there before, right? So I think we're trying to keep it simple, but still make sure that the challenge is hard. So, Roguester says, we'll gather more info this week and do some postings next week, which would probably be the best thing to do. So I've had my thing. I would say definitely come in next week, and we're going to have some chatting. So.
Mm-hmm. Okay. All right. Well, that sounds good. And we will see how that goes. So just simplifying things that are already in place, basically.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Okay. All right. Well, we'll have to talk to Ster next week. And as always, it'll be great to have him on. So looking forward to that. Yeah. All righty. So let's go on to host chat. And let's start with Nisey. What have you done this week in WoW? Tell us about it.
Oh, gosh. I didn't get a whole lot done because real life's been a pain this week and been getting in the way. Mm-hmm. But super busy. But what time I have been able to do, I managed to get to level 50 on Soulbound, and then I've been just chugging along on my main. I run a Discipline Priest on Moonrunner in a Board Gamers Network.
Okay.
And so I've just been steadily just chipping away and and I'm like, oh, this quest over here, that quest over there. I still haven't even gotten to Suramar, and I'm at 110. I'm like, oh, but I have to go do this.
Yep. Yeah.
I'm like trying to move in a straight line so I don't get distracted, and then I'm like, oh, well, now it wants to distract me by sending me all the way over to that zone.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, so I'm just basically focused on working on my main right now.
Mm-hmm. I totally understand that, so...
Oh, Leeta, do you understand? So I can't wait to hear your part of your week in the WoW challenges.
Yeah. Thanks, Stone.
Anyway, there's a bus. There's a bus coming by, and here's Leeta, and I just threw her under the bus.
Yeah. No, you didn't. You're just being nasty. Don't be nasty, Stone.
Nasty.
No being nasty. Yeah, no being nasty. Fly low, Leeta. Don't fly high. Sure.
Wow.
Anyway. Wow. Stone, what have you been up to? I did notice that you were doing some streaming via the good old Facebook.
So, whatever. Yeah, I actually got to stream on Facebook. Freaking Facebook. I just, you know, what the heck, man? So, you know, I finally... Okay, so the kids have been back at school this week. So, like, went back on Tuesday because Monday is a, you know, day off for us here, and they go back on the first Tuesday of September. That's how it always is here. And Tuesday I had things to do, Wednesday I had things to do, Thursday I had things to do, and I'm like, I want to stream, man. I haven't like streamed for so long because the kids are around. I can't stream when the kids are around because they're all over the place, man, and they're just insane. So, I mean, they fight all the time. They're like, oh, they're like saying shut up and oh, you're stupid. And, ah, man. So, you know, they're kids, right? And I can't stream when they're here. So, you know, so on Friday, the boys are at school. Carrie's at work. Nothing for me to do. And no other distractions. So, I was able to stream, and I decided to stream on Facebook just to see how it went. And, you know, and yeah, Facebook doesn't like one of my webcams for some reason. I have no idea why. For those of you that want to stream on Facebook, don't bother buying a Logitech C270 because it doesn't work. I've looked all over, and for some reason folks are having the same problem. I have no idea why. There should be no problem between this one and my C920, which is the cam that I'm using for the stream is the good one, and the cam that I'm using for the actual call is the second one, right? So it, you know, I wanted to use the second one in case, you know, I wanted to use the C20 for something else. And nope, doesn't like that one at all. So just so that you know, don't buy that if you think you're going to use a cam. Go and look up to see if your particular webcam will work with the Battle.net launcher or the Facebook page and all that stuff. So, but I got to play a mage, and I got to play my mage because I've been focusing just on a character. And I only got it to like 35. Nothing big, you know. But the big thing that I really felt was, you know, I was leveling up as Frost, and I was like, okay, I'm only gonna go Frost, right? And this is just how it's gonna be. And when we had Marg on last week, he was saying, you know, switch to Fire because after level, after like level 18 or something, it's like really good. And I switched, and I'm like, oh yeah, okay, let's see. And holy moly, Fire, yes, you don't have a pet to go help you kill stuff, but you can kill stuff before it actually gets to you. And I was like, these were not at level, so I'm still trying to play under my level because as a mage, you know, I just, you know, they're weak, right? Like they get hit and squishy. That's the word I want. They're squishy. And You know, I was having a problem in the hinterlands, and because things were starting to be kind of close to my level. I think I was like, I think I was like level, I don't know what it was. I think I was level 34, and some of them were 30, 31 or something like that. So you know, so I was starting to feel that not so good, that things were taking a long time to kill, and I was getting hit a lot. Like, no, I don't like this. So, you know, I went down to Stranglethorn Vale, and that's the first. This is going to be the first time I've taken an iron through there. So I don't know how it's going to end up. It started out at 25, right, and things have been going pretty good. There's a couple, like, things are still green to you if they're 10 levels higher. I think they have to be more than 10 levels higher in order for them to be gray. And I was like, wow, I'm still getting XP. I'm like, I'm wow. good. I'm good with this. So I'm going on my way through stuff. And yeah, and I'm actually enjoying the Fire Mage. I really am. And I'm considering, you know, seeing what the other spec is. But,
okay.
But you know, yes. Arcane, because I don't really play a mage a whole lot. I've got one mage, and she's fire. So, you know, I know fire, right? So that's a thing. So,
okay. Nice. Congrats on 35 on your mage, though. That's awesome.
Well, yeah, you know, 35. It's not a big deal, right? I mean, but so I really Maybe want this still. Mage.
Yeah, still, like, I mean, that's not bad for mage getting that far.
No, I'm waiting for Azzy to start to laugh at me in chat. I'm looking at chat. I'm waiting for him to be like, 35. I've died at, like, level 80, level 78. Level 70, I'm going to say 72 in the caves. Yeah, because that's his thing, right? So, you know, it's just, because Azzy likes to bug me too, which is okay, you know, because I get it.
Busy
I get it.
Leveling and doing.
I get it. You know, if he was close to here, I would have a beer with him. If I was close to him, I would have a beer with him. So, you know, so that's my week. You know, what I really didn't get to play a lot. It was really only about, good lord, there he goes. I was like level. I think I played for maybe 2 hours, and so I got like a level and a half, maybe ish, sort of. Hmm. So I was able to get the
but
level.
But at least you tested the streaming, so
yes, was, and Facebook works. I'm actually thinking about maybe doing. What am I gonna do? I'm maybe streaming on YouTube. Maybe I was gonna see how the other ones worked. I have streamed on YouTube before, and it was okay. I think I prefer Twitch more, just because I can get a lot of notes and seeing how people are around and all this stuff. But you know, with Facebook gaming, I know there were people watching because I'm actually trying to talk with them in the chat of the stream. But the number of people that says that is actually there, it says nothing. And I'm like, I know there's at least two people here, okay? So how can you tell me there's none? You know, it's just stuff like that. It just drives me up the wall.
And one was me, which was awesome.
Yeah, and you posted as WoW Challenges, which is okay. Listen, that's okay because you're an admin there, so it's okay. Oops, and I'm banging stuff. Here, how about I bang the mic, the microphone too? There you go.
Yeah, but that was a bit weird because I was like, no, I'm on a me, not on as the WoW Challenges.
So I thought I got hacked because all of a sudden I see somebody posted yo, and I'm like, I never posted yo. What the hell's going on? Like, oh, and then you sent me the tweet, and I'm like, oh, okay, that was you. Thank God it was you, because if it wasn't you, I was like, something's wrong.
Everyone's in the computer.
Yeah, yeah.
Who's doing that? That's weird.
So, Leeta, how about you?
Nisey, have you played? Have you tried playing Mage as a challenge tune at all, or not?
I haven't yet. Okay. My husband mains a mage, and I've been watching him get his butt kicked a little bit in Legion. And he was running Arcane, and he just switched to Fire, and he did
notice quite a bit of a difference. But I'm like, let me get the priest there first, and then maybe we'll try the mage. It's just I'm in the list, and I'm like, wow, I'm up this high, and I'm like, I'm the only clothy up this high. I'm like, I'm a little scared and intimidated, but I'm gonna keep going.
Was he saying that fire was better?
He liked fire a lot. He did notice a big damage increase on the fire. When he hit 110, he started getting kicked around a little bit again. He got a couple of pieces of gear, and it evened out.
Okay.
So it's a little gear dependent on the fire for him right now, but he likes it a lot. He was hardcore arcane. Everybody he talked to, oh, you got to play an arcane mage. Now he's playing fire, and he's kind of liking it.
Okay. Oh, cool. Well, that'll be interesting. I don't think I've tried any of the challenge tunes as a mage. I've tried a few warlocks. That's for sure. So, anyway. All right. So, Stone, my week in playing challenge tunes has been... And next, we will go on to Chit Chat.
Wow.
Nothing. Nothing. I told you.
No, it's okay. I
have been, I've got all the zones. I finished High Mountain and started into Surama, and that place is consuming my soul. That's all I'm saying. So it is just crazy. I have never come across a zone in any of Azeroth that is consuming me the way Suramaris consuming me.
I haven't even touched it yet.
Yeah, I haven't either. Yeah. I'm excited to get there. I just haven't gotten there yet.
And whether it's just me, I don't know, but it is just absolutely... It's huge. It is massive. So the other zones has got nothing in comparison to what you need to do on Surama. It's just crazy. So, but I'm trying to work on the Broken Isle, the part one of the flying achievement.
Yeah.
So I need to get it done. And it's just quests upon quests upon quests. I don't know. I don't think they track. It's now, you need to do this storyline and this storyline to complete, the whole zone.
Yep.
The amount of quests that I have done since I've been in there is crazy.
Okay.
And I have not done that many world quests. I did open up the world quests on my main. I have not looked at any other tune other than the fact that my main... needs to get this stuff done, and it is just one. And but the quest within is so interesting and consuming because I'm putting myself in, and following the lore and stuff. And I'm just like, hence why it's consuming me. So it's kind of crazy, and I won't stop until I get it finished. Like, I was even thinking the other day, I really need to have a break from this place and go, do something else. And the other part of me is like going, nah, you can't. You just have to keep going. So that's why I've not done anything, because as I said, I'm just consumed with what I'm doing in Surama. It's crazy. It's crazy good. It's crazy big. Like, it's massive. Okay. Be prepared. They've really made a massive achievement to get you get flying. Because Surama, outdoing all the other zones.
Okay. Oh, really?
In terms of quest-wise, yeah.
Really? Oh, man.
If I had have started counting my quests in Surama, I reckon I could have quite easily have done Stormheim plus High Mountain combined.
Are you kidding?
Oh, wow.
No. Don't tell. Because I'm leveling around the top, right? And I think I'm kind of almost done with Dormheim. I think I'm almost done. and I've been holding.
Stormheim's huge.
Oh like, yeah, but I've done a lot huge. There, and I think I'm almost yeah. done. And if you're telling me that Sir Ramar completely dwarfs that, then
mm-hmm.
I mean, I've been playing, and my tune is 110, and I haven't been playing my Iron Man stuff as much because what I like to do is that when a new expansion comes out, I like reading the lore, going through every single quest. I want to mm-hmm. fully experience
definitely
all the money that I'm spending on it and all the work that they put into it. You know, I want to
yeah.
do it. And that's not for everyone. That's fine. But that scares me that Sir Amar is going to be insane.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Great.
Yeah. So that's... And that is part of why it consumes me.
Yeah.
Because I do exactly the same thing. I cannot skip. It's yeah. on my main. I have to read everything. I have to sit there, you know, it's got, you've got your cinematics, you've also got, like, I've always got the music on, I've always got volume, you know,
yep.
like, noise coming through, so I hear when they're talking and all that kind of stuff. So, I am throwing myself into the game to get that whole, you know, sensory part of it, but when you're questing as well, it just... brings it to another level. And when you're just going doing this stuff that's really quite intense, you know, we're fighting demons.
Yeah.
That's what it is. We're trying to save Azeroth. That's what it is. And there's all these factors that are coming into play on so many different aspects that, you know, for me, I can't just be like, no, well, I'll go and do something else, because if I try to do something else, like if I go, right, I will go play a challenge soon, my problem is that's my first mistake, because I'm not committed, because I will hop on a challenge soon and be like, I can't commit to this, so guess who's gonna die? Like, I know how I play, so I have yeah. to be committed, you know, when I yeah. sit down to, I have to switch everything off and just be like, okay, I'm in this challenge.
Yep.
Tune, I need to be focused on that. And I'm not. I'm still thinking about a quest that I did, you know, 5 hours ago in Suramar that's kind of got me a bit, you know, it's, oh, it's absolutely. Still. So hence why I've done nothing for the challenge tunes. It will come eventually, just not at the moment. There's just no way. So yeah. But I have not deleted any. I did last week. I deleted one, and I still kind of feel like I need to cull something. I had a look. I've got like 16 challenge stones.
Oh my goodness.
Oh my god.
Why? What? Like, are you using them as scouts?
Like, no, just roll another
one. They're not scouts, right? Are they dead or are they alive or?
No, they're all just dead at various levels.
Oh, just at various levels. So yeah. They're all alive. Okay.
Mm. Because you know me. Let's just roll another alt. Why not? So, I might have to give myself some really tough love and just be like, Leeta, right, you need to cull these down a tad. Yeah. So we will see. Anyway.
So, Nisey, where are you? Do you have a character that's 110?
I do. My main Saber of Souls Discipline Priest on Moonrunner.
So are you done all of the zones, or are you doing them in order, or like what's your plan
for that? Well, I started out in Azuna because my husband started there. I'm like, okay, well, he started a little bit before me. If I have any questions, I'll ask him. Well, then when he's at work during the week, I got ahead of him. So I'm like, okay, well, then I actually had to help him get through Stormheim. And because he was a little shaky until he got some gear and, you know, it was helping me get through it faster. So I'm like, okay. And I just finished Stormheim. I'm done everything but Soramar, but I'm like trying to keep my professions up and trying to do my profession quests. And then my professions want to send me back to Azuna. And I'm like, I really need to start Suramar, but you're sending me over there. And I'm like, what am I going to do now? Like, I don't
I guess I'll go do my profession quest first, and hopefully that will send me back to Suramar, and then I can hit everything at once.
Okay.
Nice.
Okay.
Excellent. Yeah. Cool. Well, good luck. I mean, as long as you're enjoying your whole wowing experience, like,
oh yeah, not like, set just up blocks a challenge for myself. Yeah, it's like, yeah. Okay. Like, I've been like, well, I'm gonna play through this much rested when I hit not rested anymore. Then I'm gonna go back to my main for a little bit. And I've been like trying to just like chip away like half a level here, half a level there, just so I don't totally neglect her.
Yeah.
Nice. Excellent. Well, that's we will have to see where you go from in the future, most definitely. So I'm very excited for you, Priest. That is awesome of the with the Bloodthirsty. It's I'm certainly found with my druid that on the Bloodthirsty I got very let's be honest, I got very bored with just killing things probably once I hit about the nearly 30.
Oh,
like she's only what am I 30 far. About 34 I just got really but I don't know if it's because it was the druid, I just found it really struggling.
Well, I found that, like, I have to have something running in the background, whether either it's music or a show or something, just something for me to listen to.
Yeah.
Because before specs came in, it was taking me about 4 hours to get a level, and I was like, oh no, this is taking forever. Yeah. I'm never going to get there. Now, if specs came in, if I'm rested, maybe 2 hours. And that's been a big improvement. And I'm like, okay. But I have noticed, it doesn't matter what level I am, those last three bars to each level, I'm like, I'm never going to get there.
I was going to say, level 30 is pretty good, because I think I started getting bored at level 8. And I was like, I hate this. I hate it. I want a quest, man. That's what I like to do. I like to quest. I literally don't think I can do that challenge. And also with the pacifist, I don't know, man. I don't even want to think about it. I was having problems at level 2, like just driving me nuts.
Have to do a competition.
Oh,
there you go, pacifist.
Great.
We will talk about that later.
Great.
Anyway. Yeah, like I find that like beer. The lower level you are, you're leveling faster, and it's not so much of a grind. And you're like, okay, this isn't so bad. But then, as the more XP it's taking, it's like, oh, okay. It's like, wow, 130,000 XP. Yeah, okay. It's going to take a little while. And that's like, oh, and then I'm like thinking back at how much XP it was taking my main to get through higher levels. And I'm like, oh boy.
Does become a little bit daunting, but like anything, a little bit. You know, you just, all you can do is just one step at a time, one kill at a time, and they will, you know, all that XP does add up over time. But a really good point is to, you know, kind of distract yourself to a certain degree.
Yeah, with not full distraction, just a little bit, you know.
Yeah, like, yeah,
full just something distraction. Running, yeah. Yeah, no full distraction, and make sure you listen to the little voice that says, don't do that.
Yes, exactly. Alrighty. Well, how about we go on to Chit Chat? Sure. So this is where people can ask us anything, questions about the challenges, share your tips and tricks, or just warn people about potential disastrous areas, questing, all of those fun things. So, YouTube, Flame Roller, have no idea. It says, you guys really need to try that licorice she was talking about.
It's so amazing. He actually put it up a link to it because remember how last week we were talking
different about kind of
I think we were talking about mango and he posted up or he I don't know, it doesn't matter, put up a link of mango licorice, and your licorice is different than my licorice. My licorice is like Twizzler licorice, where it's thicker and kind of twisted together and not just a thin little string. Okay, so...
Okay, I'll need to send you some.
Our licorice is bigger than yours.
Licorice.
So, I will send you a pack of the licorice, although I don't think you like black licorice, right?
I'm fine.
Oh, yeah? Oh, really? Oh, okay. Please,
I just really, raspberry is my, it's, like, it's favorite.
Oh, really?
Yeah, but normal licorice is fine. No, I grew up on
you know, grandparents always having licorice and stuff. So yeah, normal is okay, which is cool.
So we did have other people sending stuff, but it was stuff that we've covered. Like, can I pick specs? Yes, you can. Just so that you know, you can pick a spec. You can. It's okay to have a spec. It's okay to change a spec. It's okay. So, the other thing was, the other questions were more around why are my characters not updating? And so I explained, you know, it's not you, it's not me. It's
it's not you, it's me.
No, it's not you and it's not me. Okay, it's Blizzard.
Sure.
So it's Blizzard. Third party. Right. Mm-hmm. So, you know, things will get resolved in time, and looks for the most part, they're getting to it, which is cool.
Yeah.
So can I say something in chit chat from chit chat from the chat room? Mm-hmm. Lysen said, freaking Azzy. Oh man. Lysen goes, he watched, 7 seasons of The Office while leveling his pacifist to 100, and yeah, I can believe that because, you know, it's pacifist, man. So, yeah.
Excellent. Alrighty. Wow. Well, Madness of Mine says, bored on Bloodthirsty. You don't know bored. Bored is grinding pirates in Tenerys for 3 rep each to go from 0 hated to 99 exalted with Booty Bay. So you don't screw up your blood sale rep at the same time. If both exalted at the same time, that's boring for an entire month.
Yeah. So, I know you have the Insane. I was working on it, and then I discovered I screwed it up, and I have to get back to back to getting hated with everyone again, because my blood sale rep is now too low, and even though I have the blood sale hat and I have the title and I have the achievement, it doesn't matter, right? Because you still need to have blood sale rep be honored or higher, right? At the same time as being exalted and all that stuff with Booty Bay and all the other 3 factions, right? And I think I screwed it up because now my Bloodthirsty is lower. It. Oh, really? Yeah. So I should be okay then?
I think, well, no. What I'm saying is I think that they may have changed it because when I did it, which was fairly early on, I didn't have to have, I could just strip everything. I didn't have to have it at the same level.
Hmm.
So back then you
Well, if you anybody knows, let me know. Strip
the rep and then build it back. As long as you hit each of the markers of having exalted on this, honored on blood sale, and exalted on all the rest, then you were okay. So,
but not at the same time.
Changed it. They may have changed it. Yeah, I'm not sure.
Okay, so well, licensing. He thinks you just need to reach it, not preserve it. Okay, so I was a little bit worried. I'm like, well, then I'm not going to do this anymore because I'm not doing that grind again. That was nuts. And then having to not be able to use the other flight paths and stuff, like, oh, come on. So, well, if it's the other way, so if I'm
stuff, flight paths,
yeah,
that does affect it.
Yeah. So,
and even that was affecting it in Warlords too, because Steam Wheel Preservation Society came into play. Not for me, because once I stripped everything back, and then I just had to build it back up. So yeah, like. Okay. Madness of Mine said, you just, you know, killing those pirates over and over and over. Yeah. You would think I'd be good at Bloodthirsty, but it's just, I don't know. If I see rep bars pop up, that's always a nice bonus.
Okay, hold on here. Back to, hold on here. Twizzlers, I assume Madness of Mind is from North America. just based on what he just said. But he says it comes in certain flavors. Strawberry, which is the one that I know, and black, which is the anise one, right?
Aniseed,
right? Okay, so, and he's saying chocolate, cherry, and rainbow. Maybe not up here, so we live
those
in
those might the- be the Twizzler pull and peels.
Oh, okay. Because, you know, up in the Great White North, we only get the two, I think.
Yeah, the standard Twizzlers are the strawberry and the anise, or anise, however you want to pronounce it.
Anise. just make sure we're pronouncing it right, otherwise you're going to get me all laughy and stuff. So,
yeah. All right, and what else did the chat room have to say? I was going to say, Ster said something before.
Scroll up.
Yeah, I'm scrolling.
Scroll.
Okay, so Ster did say that he had his scout jumped off Dalaran, swam over to Azuna, was able to do a couple of quests, like kill the sailors, find chests in boat, etc.
Yeah.
Without artifact, can't get it on Rogue.
Okay. Yeah, but we're saying that you know, it's that you can so some folks are trying to get to the quests without doing the weapon quests.
Yeah.
You know, there are quests, but there's like a handful. There's not a lot of them. So that's why we've always said that, you know, you can do the weapon quests and you can bump it up once because that's what you have to do in order to unlock all of the major zone quests in order for you to get access to everything else. You're just not allowed to use the weapon. Okay? So as soon as you get that equipped, dump it. Well, not throw it away, but put it in your bags because I think you still need it to upgrade a rune on it, I believe. And then after that, don't use it. And if we're going to see that, you know, like I've said for the last month or so, if it looks like it's impossible to level to 110 without using it, then it's on the table to discuss, you know. And, you know, it's easier to say no right now and see how it goes than it is just to say yes and then we find out, oh, it makes it really easy now, right? So it's better to say no now than say yes later. So we just need to see what happens.
Okay. What else? I think that was pretty muchly. Rogue's issue is that can't get past the artifact weapon quest, too hard. So gonna have to figure out how to get to 110 without an artifact weapon. Okay.
Yeah, my main actually died on that artifact intro scenario, and I was like, oh boy. Like, I don't know about this, but at least doing Bloodthirsty, I can just hit Levitate and just jump off of Dalaran and hope I land somewhere good.
Nice. Well, that's a good, that's a good plan. At least you're thinking ahead. That's awesome.
Trying to pre-map it out and be like, okay, this is what I'm going to do.
Yeah. All right. There are no weapon drops, so you will have to use or hit like a wet noodle.
I've seen greys drop. Yeah.
I've vended heaps of greys as I was leveling in Stormheim and Azuna as you know, 100, 101. So I know I've picked stuff up because I was like, ooh, that would be good for a challenge tune. Vendor it for 23 gold. Sweet.
Yes.
Yeah, I've been getting quite a few gray drops too. So it's like I've been hopeful. I've been like, okay, well, you know, there's some stuff dropping, so it shouldn't be too bad.
Yeah, exactly. So it'll be interesting to see. Well, we'll have to see how these guys go. They are definitely the pioneers in our challenge tunes for certain. So good luck, guys. We look forward to hearing how you guys go. So, all right. So I think it's Stone just said Carrie wants How do you say it? Foe?
Well, some people pronounce it foe. From what I understood, it's actually pronounced fa.
Fa.
Even though it's not an A, you know, whatever, it's the same thing. So, it's like we're going there once a week right after we're done the show, and we don't eat dinner, so we wait until after the show's over, and then we eat, and so we eat a lot.
Nice. Yeah. Okay. All right. Well, I think it's that time.
So, our next show will be Saturday, September the 17th, 7 p.m. North American Eastern Time, Sunday, September the 18th, 9 a.m. Australian Eastern Time, which is also 1 a.m. Central European Time. Tuli, go to bed, because it's really late for you right now. And like I mentioned earlier in the show, we will be joined by Roguester, Deadster, Ster, that's his name, and we're going to be talking about stuff.
Sterster.
That's the snobby way to say and, you know, Nisey, thank you for coming, you know.
Oh, thank you for having me. It's been great. Really love your show, guys.
Awesome.
Oh, thank you. No, we really do appreciate when people come and have a chat with us, and we do wish you all the very best. But can you tell everyone where they can find you or get in contact with you, please?
Okay, probably the two easiest ways to get a hold of me is going to be on Twitter at NiseyBGN, and probably in game on Moonrunner server on Saver of Souls in Board Gamers Network. I've started a Facebook page where it's NiseyBGN, the BGN's lowercase for Facebook. I've been trying to mess around with the Facebook streaming a little bit. My computer's not real happy about it, but we're trying to get along on that respect.
No worries. Well, I will go check it out on. I will check you out on Facebook and find the link and post that up on with the show notes, so that sounds great. And as we said, good luck with your challenge tunes, with your Bloodthirsty in particular. We wish you the very best, and enjoy your time in Legion. It is a lot of fun.
It's
certainly been different, I think, for all of us, the experience so far on our main. So
I've been enjoying this expansion a lot so far. It's definitely worth the money.
Yeah, excellent. All right, so let's see where people can find us. So we are at the website is wowchallenges.com. Don't forget, you can send us an email, which is podcast@wowchallenges.com, and check us out. We are on Facebook as well, facebook.com/wowchallenges, and YouTube is youtube.com/wowchallenges. One, that is the number one, which annoys Stone. And don't forget to come join us live every week. We are on Twitch, which is twitch.tv/wowchallenges.
Okay, so I want to say thank you to folks that help us with Patreon. I actually sent out a message, saying, hey, if you guys knew of any ways that would be good to add different things, and Awesome Trousers actually replied to me with some really great things to try. There's one I'm definitely going to try, but I need to figure it out first, and we'll go from there. So again, if you can help out, great. If not, it's okay. If you think of ways that we can, give you something back, like Q&A or helping you mount farm, I'm up for that too. Just let me know, and we'll see what we can set up. And so you can find me on Twitter @WoWChallenges, and as well as a podcast with Leeta here, another an hour and a half with you, man. I love you though.
Wow, that sounds really exciting, Star.
Well, okay, so we talk about Warcraft, just Warcraft, not Iron Man or anything like that. We're just because we play, right? So, and the Adventures in Azeroth podcast. So, wow, there you go, Leeta.
Thanks, Stone. Thanks for that, Stone. Excellent.
Wow.
Now, where people can find me. So I'm on Twitter. It's @LeetaWow, which is LEETAWOW. And don't forget, you can check out my other shows, which is Behind the Avatar, Adventures in Azeroth with him over there. And of course, Geektopia podcast. So big thanks to Mark Conan as always, because we love his intro and we even love it when it plays, which is yay. That's always exciting, Stone, which it did today.
Yes. Yeah. Yes, it did, actually.
Yes, Leeta.
That's yes, Leeta. I'm chatting.
Alrighty. So I think that's a show from us. So again, Nisey, thank you. Thank you so much for joining us. And everyone, thank you. Thanks, chat room. Bye.
See you later.
The WoW Challenges podcast is a World of Warcraft gaming podcast produced by Stone and Leeta. Copyright 2016 WoWChallenges.com. Portions of this podcast belong entirely to Blizzard Entertainment. The music used for the show belongs to Kevin MacLeod, and you can find more of his great stuff at incomnitech.com. No copyright infringement is intended.
Do you see what I mean? Do you see? Do you see?
Those computer gremlins, I'm telling you.
Like what?
That's so funny.
Like what? What? Sorry.
Thanks, chat room. That was funny. That's
no,
like
it's
the
not.
Second time we've
no,
had no music. Yeah.
But it plays. And it's like, when it's time to play, it doesn't play.
Thanks,
this is driving me nuts. Anyways, okay, I gotta get going.
Yeah. Thanks, Nisey.
Thanks for coming. I'm gonna go off the line.
So
see you guys, chat room. See you later.
Bye.